हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी चैप्टर नंबर फोर दैट इज माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल 2016। माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल 2016। तो इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी डिस्कस अबाउट द कंप्लीट टॉपिक्स इन दिस चैप्टर एंड नाउ वी विल स्टडी ईच एंड एवरी टॉपिक वन बाय वन। सो वॉट इज द फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर? फर्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज सेलेक्टिंग सेल्स। एंड वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सेलेक्टिंग सेल्स? सेलेक्टिंग सेल्स मीन्स वी कैन आइदर सेलेक्ट अ स्पेसिफिक सेल in Excel, we can also select the specific row, we can select specific column, we can select multiple rows. Okay, so I just tell you the what is the meaning of different kinds of selections. So first we can select a specific row, we can select a row, we can select a column. And third, we can select here entire worksheet, and we can also select the adjacent rows. We can also select the adjacent columns, and finally we can also select adjacent rows, columns, and non-adjacent. We can select non-adjacent rows, and finally last non-adjacent columns. So these are the different kinds of selections available. Once again we can see: select a row, select a column, select entire worksheet, and select adjacent rows, adjacent columns, and select non-adjacent rows and non-adjacent column. So just we can look how to perform the following actions. So first we discuss about how to select a row. To select a specific row, what we have to do? We just have to click on the row heading. To select a row, click on the row heading. Okay, row heading. Just by clicking on the row heading, we can select a specific row. So how to do it? So just I tell you in MS Excel, how the sheet will look like and how to select a specific row. So suppose this is the Excel sheet, and we have different rows like this. For example, row 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., and these are the columns A, B, C, D, E, etc., etc. To select the specific row, these rows, what we have to do? These are the row headings here. Okay, to select any specific row, just click on the row heading, any specific row heading, then the entire row will be selected. The complete row will be selected by just clicking on the row heading. Okay, got it? And similarly, next point is how to select a specific column. Select a column. To select a column, we have to do the same process. We have to perform the same action. So what we have to do, just click on the column heading. Column heading. Okay. Just by clicking on the column heading, we can select the specific column. For example, just look at the picture, look at the diagram that I have drawn earlier. These are the columns, specific columns you can see. To select a column, just click on the, these are the column headings here, A, B, C, D, E, and so on. These are the column headings. To select a column, just click on the any column heading. Then the complete column will be selected just by click on the specific column heading. Okay. So now come to the next point. We have seen how to select a row and how to select a column. So just come to the next topic, and this topic is select entire worksheet. Select entire worksheet. Okay. So to select entire worksheet, what we have to do? So there is a simple method for complete selection, is that just press Ctrl plus A. This is the shortcut key, Ctrl plus A. This is the key combination. With the help of this key combination, we can select the entire worksheet. Okay. And there is another method. Another method is that there is a symbol like this on the specific sheet. There is a symbol on the sheet like this. You must have noticed about this symbol. So these are the rows here and these are the columns. This is any specific sheet, actual sheet that I have drawn here. Okay, these are here. Once again, these are the columns, these are the columns, and these are here rows. So how to select the entire worksheet? Just I have told you, press Ctrl plus A or click on this symbol here. This symbol demonstrate select all. This is the select all button. Okay, this is the select all button. So just by clicking on this button, the entire worksheet will be selected. Okay, so now come to the next point, and next topic is how to select adjacent rows. Select adjacent rows. So first, we must know what is the meaning of adjacent rows. Adjacent. The meaning of adjacent is that, suppose these are different rows. These are different rows. Row number 1. This is row 1. Row 2. Row 3. And row 4. And row 4 like this. These are the various rows here. So these all continuous rows will be called as, all the continuous rows will be called as adjacent rows. These are the adjacent rows. Okay. So what we have to do to select the adjacent rows? So there is a method to select adjacent rows. Just we can select the row or column. First, then hold down the shift key. After that, hold down the shift key while you select the last row. Means, what we have to do? Click on any specific row. Okay. Then hold down the shift key. Hold down the shift key. And then click on the last row. Click on the last row that you want to select. Click on the last row here. Okay. Shift. First click on a specific row. Then hold down shift key. The shift key. And then click on the last row up to which you have to select the adjacent rows. Then the rows, adjacent rows will be selected. Okay. So this is the method to select adjacent rows. And in the similar way, we can select, okay, we can select the specific column in the same way. Specific, we can select specific column. So just I draw once again the columns or Excel sheet like this, A, B, C, D and E. Okay. So to select all these columns from A to E. Okay. So what we have to do? Select all these columns. So we have to follow the same process. Click on any column. Okay. Hold down the shift key. Shift key. Okay. Press shift key. And then click on the last column up to which you have to select the columns. Then complete adjacent columns will be selected. Okay. Got it? So in the same way, just click once again. Click. So click and hold shift key and then click on the last row or column. Click last row or column. Okay, last row or column. So in this way we can select adjacent rows and columns. We can select adjacent rows and columns. Okay, so these are the method to select specific row, to select adjacent rows and adjacent columns, etc. Now we come to the next topic, that is entering numbers as text. Next topic is entering numbers as text. What is the meaning of entering numbers as text? So as I discussed you earlier about this topic, that sometimes we need a specific kind of data. For example, consider area code. Area code in the phone numbers. And consider your roll numbers. So for example, any roll number may start from 0. Like 01211105. Like this, any roll number may be like this. Similarly, any area code may also contain zero, like for example 05732, like this. So how to enter this kind of data in Excel? Suppose you are entering this data 05732 in Excel cell and you have pressed enter key. Then what will happen? Excel will remove this zero. Excel will remove this 05732. Okay. So this area code will be entered wrongly. Okay. Similarly, if you are entering any roll number, then that roll number, the before any zero before the number will be, any number before the zero will be removed by Excel. So what to do? How to enter these kinds of data? Because we need zero in before the number. In our roll number we are having zero, so we need to add zero. So how to do it? So there is a method to do it, to enter these kinds of data. There is a method that add a symbol that is called as apostrophe. Add a symbol that is called apostrophe. This is like this before the number. Okay. Now this number can be entered in Excel, and now this zero will not be removed. So now by just adding this apostrophe, what happened? This number has converted into text. Now this number is not a number while this is a text. Okay, so this is the method how to enter number as a text. So in previous case the two numbers can be added. For example, we are having any two numbers, like suppose 15 plus 20, and in Excel we can add these two numbers. So answer will be 35. Okay. But now if we are having like this 015, okay, plus 0 apostrophe 020, now the answer will not be 35. There will be no 35. Okay. Now 35 will not be the answer. So we cannot perform the numerical calculations like this, arithmetic calculations like plus minus etc. If we have to perform these kinds of actions, then the result will be something different as in case of text. How the result of text appears will be the result of the these kinds of numbers, or these are texts. So we can say these are not numbers now. What are these? These are text now. These are text. Okay. So we have studied now that how to enter a number as a text. So now discuss the next topic. Next topic is entering date and time. Entering date and time. Entering date and time. So what are the different kinds of dates? How do we write dates? Suppose there is today is 4 June. June 4, 2020. So how to write this date? Like 4/6, month name, after that year 20, or you can also write it 4-6-2020, or we can also write it like this June 4, 2020. We can also write it 4 June 2020. So what are these? These are the different kinds of date formats. These are the date formats. These are the available date formats. So different kinds of date formats are supported by Excel. So how to do it? Just type any date and press enter, and Excel will automatically support this kind of date format. Okay. But suppose you have to enter any specific date format. You have to convert your date format into any specific date format. So there is a way to convert date format. So how to do it? So to display date formats, just we have to click on the home tab. So just I am telling you how to enter a specific date format. Date format in Excel. So just go to home tab. Okay. Then go to the sales group. Sales group. Then click on format. Just go to home tab. Click on sales group. And then click on format. So in this way, you can find date. You can find date in category list. So you can choose any specific type of date format. As I have discussed earlier, this different kinds of date formats are available, and you can select any date format. These formats will be available in Excel, and you can choose any of the date format. Then that date form, when you enter the date, then your date will be on the specific date format also. Okay. So in this way, you can perform the various actions that I have told you. So we have covered in this video the selection of cells and entering numbers as a text. And finally, we have discussed about the date format of entering date and time. So in our next videos, we will discuss about changing cell contents. So we will discuss these topics later.